First thing tomorrow morning, a plane full of our nation's heroes will leave Milwaukee.
New at 10 tonight, Patrick Paolantonio reports on the history-making trip to honor World War II veterans and the new mission for those who fly them to Washington, D.C.
Here's a picture.
The picture shows an 18-year-old ready to serve.
Right out of high school, I joined the Air Force.
Today, Bob Birmingham is in his late 80s, holding close his scrapbook of military memories.
On every flight, you know, they took pictures of the target.
These shots are from that fateful mission over Germany in 1945.
And we took a direct hit from anti-aircraft shell. Right after we dropped our bombs, with the bomb bay doors open, the shell came up through the open bomb bay and lodged into the main gas tank, which is right in the wing.
Losing fuel and altitude, the crew raced for neutral ground. They made it.
This is where we landed.
To Sweden.
That was your airplane?
The mangled wreckage, the remains of their crashed airplane documented in photos. The crew was interned, held in neutral Sweden for months. Books tell their story, this one written in Swedish. Now, nearly 70 years after the crash, he's leaving on another mission.
I've been to Washington, D.C., but before the memorial. I have not seen the memorial.
This weekend, he'll see the World War II memorial for the first time when he boards the Stars and Stripes Honor Flight. The organization flies World War II veterans there for free, a one-day trip to Washington, D.C., so they can see their memorials. 12 News went along in 2011, so did Renee Riddle.
There's always something magical that happens.
She's been on several honor flights, the granddaughter of a World War II veteran, mother of three, and one of 600 people who volunteer their time to make this happen.
It's just such an honor and a privilege to be able to give someone a gift like this in really the final chapter of their lives.
A gift given to more than 2,500 World War II veterans in southeast Wisconsin since Stars and Stripes started flying out of Milwaukee 5 years ago.
I think people in their hearts really get this mission. They also get the sense of urgency, particularly with the World War II veterans, with 900 of them passing away every single day. There's been this sense of urgency. So we couldn't be more pleased with Operation Resolve becoming Operation Resolved now.
Resolved because the group says it's gone through its wait list. Saturday's flight is their 17th and the last flight exclusive for World War II veterans.
I'm excited to go. I think it'll be a fun day.
A day, he also tells us, he waited to sign up for.
I've been given so many honors already when these books were written and when, you know, everybody knew my story then, you know, and I think this trip should be more for the guys who were dodging bullets every day and never got a pat on the back.
On his back, he'll wear the honor flight jacket when he adds another chapter to his military story. In Greendale, Patrick Paolantonio, WISN, 12 News.
Now, Stars and Stripes will still fly World War II veterans who have not made the trip, but starting in June, they'll include Korean War veterans on those flights. Already, the organization says it has a wait list of 500 Korean War vets. You can follow their journey from WISN.com. We have a slideshow of their send-off and return home.